The Toyota 5VZ-FE can generally make it to 300,000 to even 500,000 or more miles with very few issues along the way. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the Toyota 5VZ-FE reliability and common problems. The Toyota 5VZ-FE is a 3.4 liter V6 engine produced from 1995 until 2004. It's best known for its use in the Toyota T100, Tacoma, Tundra, and 4Runner of that era. The Toyota 5VZ-FE is often considered one of Toyota's most reliable engines of all time, so it's really an incredibly reliable engine that really doesn't suffer from any design flaws or truly common issues. But with that said, we are talking about an engine that is roughly 20 to 30 years old, and any engine with that kind of age and the likely mileage do contribute to a couple issues that pop up on the 5VZ as these engines have continued aging. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump right in and discuss a few of the most common problems with the Toyota 5VZ-FE. Number one on the list, we have oil leaks, and more specifically valve cover gasket oil leaks. Now, this isn't a design flaw. It's something that I wouldn't even consider fair to call a problem, and especially not a common problem. However, as I mentioned briefly in the intro, this is a 20 to 30 year old engine nowadays, and anything like gaskets, seals, O-rings, any rubber or rubber-like materials are simply prone to degradation with that kind of age and mileage. So with an engine like the 5VZ-FE, despite how reliable it is, no engine has defeated Father Time, and that's certainly true again with those rubber or rubber-like components. So oil leaks are going to be something that pop up from time to time on this engine. Symptoms are very straightforward with a valve cover gasket oil leak. You might notice a visible leak or oil spots on the ground after parking the vehicle. You might notice burning oil smells and low oil levels, and potentially some smoke from the engine bay. Fortunately, with the 5VZ-FE, this is a very easy engine to work on top of being incredibly reliable. These valve cover gaskets are about $40 to $50 in parts. If you end up at a repair shop, it's going to be a few hours in labor, so you'll likely end up spending somewhere between about $250 to $400 on labor. So ultimately, really not terribly expensive relative to the cost of valve cover gaskets on some other engines and other vehicles. Moving on to common problem number two. Once again, this is by no means a common problem. It's not truly common, and it's really not even fair to consider an issue, and that's head gasket failure. Head gasket failure is something that really tends to pop up in that 200 to 300,000 plus mile ballpark, which is outside of a reasonably expected lifespan for a head gasket. A lot of different engines and vehicles suffer from head gasket failures, especially as they pass that 150, 200,000 mile ballpark. Really goes to show just how reliable this engine is, but head gasket failure is something worth mentioning just because head gasket failure is serious, and it can be a very costly repair bill. Oftentimes, replacing a failed head gasket can be about $1,000 to $1,500+ job. Really depends if you're going to replace anything else or have anything else replaced while you're in there. And ultimately, it's really not that expensive if you can DIY it, but a head gasket can be a more challenging DIY job unless you're really experienced and have good knowledge working on vehicles and engines. Now, these are reliable engines, so it could still be worthwhile. And if you're going to invest that kind of money while you're doing the head gasket, it could also be a good time to knock out some other general maintenance on these engines, the timing belt, water pump, etc., things that I'm going to discuss in just a moment here. Moving on to our final thing on this list here, problem number three, we have the timing belt and water pump. The timing belt is really just a standard maintenance item. It should be replaced roughly every 7 to 10 years, or about 80 to 120,000 miles. The exact service interval calls for 90,000 mile changes. So the timing belt is really just a standard maintenance item that should be replaced roughly every 7 to 10 years, or about 80 to 90,000 miles. While you're in there doing the timing belt, the water pump is a good thing to address, just because a lot of the times water pumps useful lives are about 120 to 180,000 miles. So every time you replace the belt, it doesn't hurt to just go ahead and do the water pump as well, or at least every other time you replace the belt. But ultimately, if you need a belt replacement, and the water pump is older, it's a great thing to replace, really not that expensive, and it's very easy to replace when the timing belt is already coming off of the engine anyway. So just something to keep in mind there, really not common problems, again, just more so a standard maintenance item with the timing belt. And water pumps are really only designed to last about 120 to 180,000 miles. So in summary of all of that, and talking about overall reliability of the Toyota 5VZ-FE engine, this is again an incredibly reliable engine. Hopefully I made that clear throughout the video. It is up there as potentially the most reliable Toyota engine of all time, and even if you can argue something else deserves that top spot, it's certainly one of the top three most reliable Toyota engines of all time. And ultimately, Toyota being a reliable brand, this engine is also among the most reliable production engines in passenger vehicles in general. So really an incredible engine, thinking about all the stuff that I talked through in this video with some of the quote-unquote common problems. None of them are really common problems or fueled by any design flaws or issues with the engine, and it's really rare to come across that. Almost every other internal combustion engine in the world, there's at least a couple things you could pick out that were common issues at, you know, 60,000, 100,000 miles. But in the case of the Toyota 5VZ-FE, this was really a darn near bulletproof engine, and some of these problems really only started becoming a bit more common as these engines hit that 10, 15 plus year old mark, as well as 150 to 200,000 plus miles. So in terms of longevity and the lifespan of this engine, the Toyota 5VZ-FE can generally make it to 300,000 to even 500,000 or more miles with very few issues along the way. Again, there just really aren't any design flaws or issues with this engine. Apart from that higher mileage, you're going to start running into a couple small issues from time to time. Water pump failure, oil leaks from the valve cover gaskets, and potentially leaks from any other seals, gaskets, O-rings, hoses, etc. But stuff that can be said about pretty much any 15, 20, 20 plus year old engine. So again, really truly an excellent engine and one of the most reliable engines of all time. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.